So welcome to the second chapter. You can see it, right? Stop pretending that you are rich. So what do I mean by saying stop pretending you're rich? Many people do not tell their family how much money they have. Now that's okay on the being on the conservative side. Suppose you have a 30 crore net worth and your family thinks you have a 3 crore net worth. That's okay. But the problem is sometimes you communicate in such a way that you have a 2 crore net worth and your family thinks you have a 20 crore net worth. Why am I saying this? This comes into question very regularly these days when I'm having a conversation with parents who can't understand how to make their children understand that they cannot afford to send them abroad for further studies. How much is the budget? Well, if it's a good quality college, etc., along with the application form and paying fees to some guy who will help you get into a good college in US, the total cost comes to approximately 2 crores, right? 2 crore Indian rupees. Now that's not a small amount of money, right? You're talking of a big amount of money. For most Indians, this is a big amount of money and it's a serious amount of money. Now the problem is children have no idea as to how much their fathers have. For example, I know one boy who's asking his father to pay for a hotel management education in Switzerland, which is costing him approximately 90 lakhs. The father has a net worth of about 2 crores, right? But the father cannot say no to the boy because the father is a divorcee and the mother has said all education expenses will be borne by the father. Now the father doesn't want to cut a sorry figure and say, I can't afford it. But that's the truth. He can't afford it. If you have 2 crores, can you afford to give away 1 crore for your son's education? The answer is no. And he's not young. So my take on that was to say, just say no, you can't afford it. So saying, no, I can't say that because my son will feel bad that if we were together, would I not have paid? This is all nonsense. The fact is today you're not together. You can't afford to pay, right? So what are all the indications that I see that parents pretend to have a much higher bank balance than what kids think, or rather kids think that the parents have a much higher bank balance than the reality. What happens is, first of all, as a sane person, you should provide for your own retirement before you provide for your children's expenses, because your own retirement is something for which you can't borrow and for which only you have to provide. For your children, there's a chance that somebody else will provide. I mean, they can get a scholarship if they deserve it, right? So those options are available. But for retirement, there are no options available. It has to be just your money. You cannot borrow. You cannot do a whole house mortgage, reverse mortgage. Nothing you can do till you're 70, 75. And by the time your building may be too old, you may have to sell it and buy a new house so that you can do a reverse mortgage. Believe me, life is not so simple. So how do you go and tell your children that you cannot afford that $200,000 course or that vacation to Disneyland or any of those things? So dad, we must see animals. So you're happy to take them to Africa. All that is great. But the question to ask yourself constantly is, have you provided for your own retirement? If you have provided for your own retirement and you're going to have a simple retirement, then life is fine. But what happens if you don't? How will you tell your children all these things? How will you say that, look, I met one person and his net worth is 1 crore at the age of 51. And according to my estimate, he needs 6-7 crores for retirement. That is at the age of 70, or rather at the age of 60. He may be able to push it by 1 or 2 years. And then what happens, right? The whole floodgates open saying, oh, I had this problem, he had this problem. So first of all, we are pretending by saying the company has not done this or the company has not done that. That's not material, right? What you have to know is whether you have created enough money for your pensions, right? So if it costs $200,000 for that education abroad, bad luck, but you can't really afford it. You are, let's say you're 47 years of age, you're unemployed and perhaps unemployable, though you may not accept it. Then how will you pay for your daughter's foreign education? What happens if your daughter is already there and she's saying that she's already studying there and you have to pay the EMI? How are you going to pay the EMI? You haven't told her also that you have lost your job, right? So your kids cannot afford those big expensive $1 million education and $500,000 kind of education simply because they can't afford it and you can't afford it and you are funding it. It is high time that you told your children the real truth about your status, the real truth about how you live your life, right? And stop pretending that you are rich. Many, many indicators there. If you buy expensive shirts, if you buy expensive perfumes, if you buy expensive shoes from expensive showrooms, obviously they can see all that, right? So good financial habits are caught. It cannot really be taught. So see what you're doing and then plan your life accordingly. Thank you.